If you gather today's most popular browsers, you'll notice that a good chunk of them use Chromium as a base. Brave, Edge, Vivaldi, Opera, and Chrome.
Obviously.
But there are others with different engines. Safari, Firefox, and of course a bunch of Firefox forks. Firefox? Anyway, what exactly is a Chromium browser? Is it good? Is it bad? And are non-Chromium browsers somehow better? So first things first, we're not talking about the chemical element here, though that's exactly where Chromium got its name from. Chromium is a free and open source web browser project primarily developed by Google. Anyone can see, use, and modify its code, all 40 gigabytes of it. It's a truly glorious beast, written all in C++. I even saw someone comparing it to the Lord of the Rings trilogy, multiplied 13,000 times in terms of lines of code. Anyway, Chromium itself can be split into three main parts. There's Blink, the rendering engine that takes the code of a website and displays it visually on your screen. Then you've got V8, the part that processes the dynamic parts of the website and makes them interactive. And then there's the basic user interface, which has the main parts of a browser like tabs, an address bar, bookmarks, etc. By itself, Chromium looks like an aggressively disinfected Google Chrome browser. Yet comparing it to Chrome is kind of like the chicken or the egg question. They were worked on and came out at the same time. But back then, in 2008, Chromium was basically all of Chrome's code. Then Chrome moved on to do bigger corporate things and gradually had more and more things implemented. Automatic updates, integration with Google services, media docs for playing videos and audio, blah, 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 all that sort of good stuff. Meanwhile, Chromium stayed as a free-to-use base layer for anyone who wanted it. Sure, you can kind of use it as a browser by itself, but it lacks many, many things to work smoothly, so it's much better to use as a starting point. And boy, did people use it! Opera, for example, uses it as the foundation, but with added features like an ad blocker, workspace management tools, and their built-in VPN. Microsoft Edge also uses Chromium. They actually moved from their own engine to Chromium in 2020, finally fixing their terrible speeds and outdated UI. Okay, Opera and Edge are kind of meh, but Chromium was used in some more impressive projects too. For example, the Brave browser was based on Chromium with added privacy features and inbuilt ad blocking. Vivaldi too is an insanely customizable browser as they put a ton of features and settings on top of the Chromium web browser base. The four of these are only the few most used browser names. There are so many more developers that grabbed Chromium and built something of their own. And I get it. Why start from scratch if you can get such a huge portion of the work already done? And done well, admittedly. There are a ton of developer tools in there. Plus, Chromium is genuinely known to be fast and stable, which is what all of us want our browsers to be. However, Chromium also came with a couple of drawbacks. The main cause of concern is the association with Google. Google maintains the core of Chromium, and they're not really known for being privacy friendly now, are they? But in my humble opinion, these concerns are much more applicable to Chrome than Chromium. The base doesn't have all the data tracking shenanigans installed onto it. Google Chrome added those on top. Sure, it can be argued that Chromium provides a good base for doing these things, but it's like being mad at a blank page for providing a canvas. That said, if you pick a random Chromium-based browser, you might be unknowingly feeding your data to its developers or to Google, as you wouldn't really see what's in the code. But there are privacy-focused Chromium browsers too that strip all interactions with Google services. Brave is my favorite example, and they even left their whole browser open source so people could see that they're not collecting data for Google or even for themselves. That said, there is one thing that's likely to affect all Chromium browsers. It is the manifest V3 update. With it, Google is pretty much purging ad blockers. uBlock Origin already fell victim to it, and now there are only a few ad blockers that will still work properly on Chrome. If you want my recommendations on that front, I left a couple of links in the description. My favorite ad blocker for now comes from Surfshark. Their Clean Web 2.0 feature is in the Surfshark browser extension, and I guess they avoided Manifest V3 Grass primarily being a VPN app. Total Adblock worked well in my test too for both regular and video ads. Anyway, so far, other Chromium-based browsers are holding on against the Manifest V3 update. They're probably using the previous version and will continue to for as long as they can, but Google seems bent on serving us ads and leaving no way to avoid them. So it might be only a matter of time before they enforce this harder. Another thing that bothers me is a little known fact that the internet has come to rely mostly on one type of browser. Chrome itself dominates 65% of the browser market, and if you add up all the other browsers that use Chromium, that's over 85% of all browsers. It's pretty much a Chromium web browser monopoly at this point. So it's not a great thing for diversity and innovation. But not all hope is lost. There are other engines too. Gecko, for example, is the engine behind Firefox and its various forks. Firefox. It's open source as well, developed by Mozilla, which is now a non-profit organization, and they don't enforce the Manifest V3 BS. However, Gecko is just an engine. It has no UI included, and Firefox itself has dealt with some backlash recently over vague terms of service updates that seemingly claimed rights to all user uploaded content. So Firefox is being ditched by a lot of users, though the Firefox are still going strong. Another pretty famous web engine is WebKit, developed by Apple for Safari. They also enforce that all iOS browsers would use this, so even Chrome on your iPhone is not actually Chrome. Unless you're from Europe, the EU has your back. They love bullying Apple into sensible decisions. Of course, there are some lesser known engines too. Goanna is a fork of an older version of Gecko used in browsers like Pale Moon. I'm not saying I recommend this one, but it exists, with a logo of literally just a blurred moon picture. Servo is an experimental browser engine written in Rust, initially developed by Mozilla and now moved to the Linux Foundation. The Lady Web browser is powered by LidWeb, built from scratch for the Serenity OS project. This one is basically Windows 98 in terms of UI, just without the lag. Hopefully, I haven't tried it yet, but honestly, looking at the UI, I'm tempted. Anyway, the thing is, these engines are pretty much tiny underground projects compared to Chromium. Though, who knows, maybe one of them will become mainstream someday and push Google from the throne. Either way, what you've probably realized already is that there's no clear winner between Chromium and non-Chromium browsers. Unless you're bent on not touching anything made by Google, good luck with that. But hey, there's a Reddit support group just for you. If you simply want a good browser recommendation, there is no single best browser that tops all of them. But here are some of my current favorite ones, both Chromium and non-Chromium. I already mentioned Brave. It is one of the best Chromium-based browsers to me, with heavy focus on privacy, good ad blocking, and fast performance. The Vivaldi web browser is also great for those who want to customize their browser as much as they can. You can literally get lost in their settings and features for hours. Waterfox is a great non-Chromium option. It's lighter than Firefox, more transparent in their privacy practices, with the main focus on speed and efficiency. It also supports extensions, even on Android, which is a big plus for me. Alternatively, look into Zen. It's another Firefox, a private browser with a clean aesthetic design and good speeds. Plus, their devs are always lurking on Reddit and responding to feedback, so it's really cool to see. If you're interested, I have more thorough browser reviews on the channel and a ton of other content, so check it out. Until next time, guys, check out the links in the description, and I will see you in the next one.